The tomb path used to be a slope. The steps were built for convenience. This is the doorway for the whole tomb. This is the arch. It has five rings. The main function of the arch is to support the upper structure of this tomb. The tomb door is important, as it was built as a door connecting our world and the next world in ancient China.
Ko said this tomb is divided into six sections, including a front room, middle room, and back room. There are 72 drawings in the tomb depicting the life of the tomb's owner, showing him farming, hunting, and cooking.
The drawings in the front room show the power and wealth of the family, while the drawings in the middle room describe the leisure life of the owner. These are the depictions of Fuxi and Nüwa, who are described in Chinese mythology as creating humanity. These pictures also show the daily life of the owner. You see, there are people dancing and making music, women being accompanied by maids and so on.
In the deserts of Gaotai County in Gansu, thousands of mounds can be seen stretching for miles. This is the Shu San Wan tomb complex, which remained a mystery for more than 1,000 years until recently.
The Shu San Wan tomb complex covers about 30 square kilometers, including 6,000 to 7,000 tombs above the ground, and even more under the earth. From the scale of the tomb complex, it is safe to say that there used to be a large population here dating back to the Han and Wei dynasties, which makes them about 100 years old.
The tombs feature a massive underground gallery with thousands of colorful drawings on the inner walls. More than 400 bricks featuring ancient drawings have been excavated from the complex since 1996. The drawings, along with the frescoes found in grottos located along the ancient Silk Road, depict life as it was in the Hexi Corridor, an important trade route that stretched from North China to Central Asia.
As we know, Hexi Corridor is well known for its large volume of art, such as the frescoes of Dunhuang grottos and tomb brick drawings here in Gaotai. They reveal the life of local people in ancient times from different aspects. The frescoes of Dunhuang grottos focus on religion, while the tomb brick drawings here focus on daily life.
During the Wei and Jin dynasties, about 1,400 years ago, a stable environment and booming exchanges in the Hexi Corridor made it one of the most prosperous areas along the Silk Road. A large number of people from both inner China and neighboring countries settled down in Hexi.
There are many images of businessmen from Central Asia in the drawings found on tomb bricks on earth in Gaotai County. This suggests that Silk Road was open and exchanges between China and neighboring countries were active at that time.